Hello friends, today we will learn about the weak form type methods. What is weak form type method? Weak form type method is nothing but the order of differential equation is to be reduced to half. So the same problem we will solve by using Rayleigh's methods. Okay, so this is step number one, which will be the approximate solution. We already learned that how we will find approximate solutions in step number one. Okay, so by using this step approximate solution, we will solve this Rayleigh's methods. Okay, so what is the first step? The first step for solving Rayleigh's method, the step number one. So what is Wi? Wi is nothing but wet function and R is nothing but residue. So Wi will be written as it is, and R is nothing but our differential equation. So which is nothing but 3 d square y upon dx square minus dy by dx plus 8 dx is equals to 0. Now we will solve this integration by using parts methods. So first we will separate this integration. So 0 to 1 Wi 3 d square y upon dx square minus 0 to 1 wi dy by dx plus 0 to 1 8 wi dx is equals to 0. So here also one operator will be there, dx, and here also one operator. Okay. So now we will solve this integration. Let's see first integral parts. So for solving this integration, we will require integration by parts method, which is known as the UV methods. So what is the rule of UV? We already know the UV rule is nothing but U integration of V minus big integration V integrations into derivative of U. This is known as the integration by parts method. We will apply by this integration. So by applying this, we will get 0 to. So let's first understand what is u and what is v. So if I'm saying that, if I have to solve this 0 to 1, so 3 is a constant. So we will take outside the integration wi d square y upon di square. So we have to solve this integration by using this uv. So I will consider this is as a u and this is as a v. So by according to rule, this will be 3 will be outside. So u written as it is, integration of v, that is nothing but integration of d square y upon dx square, 0 to 1 is the integral limits, then minus sign minus big integration 0 to 1 integrations of d square y upon dx square dx my into derivative of u, that is nothing but dwi upon dx and capital dx. So this integration of this term will be, we already know that it will be dy by dx. Okay, so again this will be the same 0 to 1 dy by dx and derivative of wet functions will be written as it is. So dx. Okay, so this is a step number one, step part one integrals. Okay, now we will substitute this integration in this equation. So I will get, we will consider this is the name as a equation number one. We'll put this equations in equation number one. So I will get, this will be 3 wi into dy by dx minus 0 to 1 dy by dx into dwi upon dx. Similarly, remaining is 0 to 1 wi dy by dx dx plus 0 to 1 8 wi dx is equals to 0. Okay, so we will multiply these three through whole brackets. So I will get 3wi dy by dx minus 3021 dy by dx dwi dx minus 021 wi dy by dx capital DX plus 021 8wi dx is equals to 0. Okay, so now we'll keep this term as a, so we will put integration's limit here. Yeah, so this is become 3wi dy by dx 10. We will put this data on right hand side, so I will get 3021 dy by dx dwi dx minus, sorry, minus become plus, so this is become plus 021 wi dy by dx dx plus 021, sorry, plus become minus, so this is become minus 8wi dx. Okay, so already Rayleigh's method is nothing but you have to make the order of differential equation to reduce to half. Okay, so my differential equation order is 2, so this means by using this method I have to make this order as a 1, because the order of differential equation is 1 and reduce to half is nothing but you have to make this 1, and I already make it is as a 1. So I will see now the boundary condition. The boundary condition is y of 0 is equals to 1 and y of 1 is equals to 2. This approximate solution is already depend on this essential boundary condition. Essential boundary condition is nothing but primary variable. So I know that this my whole both boundary conditions are primary boundary condition, which is known as the essential boundary condition. So according to that, I will get this term as a 3 into 0, because if I am seeing that this is my secondary variable, and the boundary condition associated is known as a natural boundary condition. But if I am seeing these two boundary condition, I didn't get any secondary boundary condition or natural boundary condition. So there, due to insufficient data and insufficient information, we will treat this is as a 0 because I don't have this is a natural boundary condition. So this is become 0. So 3 into 0 is equals to 3021 dy by dx into dwi dx plus 021 wi dy dx dx minus 021 8wi dx. Please remember, this is become 0 since natural boundary condition is not given in problem. Okay, so this is become 3 into 0, so which is known as a 0. 0 is equals to 3021 dy by dx dwi dx plus 021 wi dy dx dx minus 8021 wi dx. So what is wi? We will see what is wi. So according to the tables, we all learn that what is wi. Wi is nothing but a weight function. So we will write the weight function. What is weight function for Rayleigh's method? Weight function of Rayleigh's method is nothing but the coefficient of ci in polynomial, which is nothing but y. So what is y? The y equation is nothing but 1 plus x plus c2 x square minus x plus c3 x cube minus x. So I have a two parameter, one is c2 and second is c3. So we will require two weight function. So according to this polynomial, weight function 1 will be associated with to c2 and weight function 2 will be associated with to c3. So let's see W1. So W1 will be coefficient of C2. Coefficient of C2 in polynomial. So coefficient of C2 is here is x square minus x. So my W1 will be x square minus x. And I already have a y equations. So this is become. So we will find dy by dx also. We will differentiate this equation. So I will get one derivative is 0, x derivative is 1 plus this is become c2 2x minus 1 plus c3 3x square minus 1. So I already find w1. I have a dy by dx. Just I will put this w1 and this dy by dx in this equation. So I will get 0 is equals to 3 0 to 1. So dwi by dx. So you have to find dwi by dx. I will find here. So dw1 by dx. So I will get this is as a 2x minus 1. I will differentiate this with respect to x. So I have a dw by dx and dy by dx. I will put this in equation. I will get 2x minus 1 and this is become 1 plus c2 2x minus 1 plus c3 3x square minus 1. This is one bracket. Okay, plus next is 0 to 1 w1. So we have to write w1 only. So I will get x square minus x into dy by dx. So I will write 1 plus c2 2x minus 1 plus c3 3x square minus 1. So this is one bracket complete. Then third term is minus 8 w1, which is nothing but x square minus x dx. So I have to solve this three equations. Now we will solve this three integration as a part by part. So we will first solve this first integration. So this is become I1. I will consider this is as a I1. This will be as a I2 and this will be as a I3. So I will solve for I1. So I1 is nothing but 3, 0 to 1. First we will solve these brackets. So for solving this I will get 2x plus c2 2x into 2x minus 1 plus c3 2x into 3x square minus 1. Okay, then I will multiply this 1 to this bracket. So I will get minus 1 as it is. This is become same to same c2 2x minus 1 plus c3 3x square minus 1 bracket complete, and this is bracket will be the next bracket will be complete. Okay, so this is become what 3 will be multiplied this throughout the bracket. So first we will solve this bracket. I will get 3 into 0 to 1 2x plus c2. So I will multiply this. I will get 4x square minus 2x plus c3 6x cube minus 2x minus 1 minus c2 2x minus 1 minus c3 3x square minus 1, and this is the bracket complete. So this is become dx and bracket complete. So you have to multi integrate all this term. So after integration this I will get 3. So integration of this will be 2x square by 2. Integration of this term will be 4x cube by 3 minus 2x square by 2 plus c3 6x raised to 4 upon 4 minus 2x square upon 2 minus x minus c2 2x square by 2 minus x minus c3, 3x cube by 3 minus x, and the whole bracket will be completed and the integration limit will be 0 to 1. So I will put upper limit and minus lower limit in this equation. So I will get, so 2 by 2 plus c2, 4 by 3 minus 2 by 2 plus c3, 6 by 4 minus 2 by 2 minus 1 minus c2, 2 by 2 minus 1 minus c3, 3 by 3 minus 1, and bracket complete. So I will put this in equation in this calci and I will find the integral value of that. So now we will solve for I2. So I2 will be, first we will multiply this bracket. So after multiplying this, I will get x square plus c2. I directly multiply, will get 2x cube minus x square plus c3, 3x raised to 4 minus x square minus x minus c2, 2x square minus x minus c3, 3x cube minus x dx. So integration of this will be x cube by 3 plus c2, 2x raised to 4 minus x cube by 3 plus c3, 3x raised to 5 minus x cube by 3 minus x square by 2 c2, 2x cube by 3 minus x square by 2 minus c3, 3x raised to 4 by 4 minus x square by 2 and 0 to 1. So now I will put this equation, put upper limit and lower limit in this equation. So according to that, I will 1 by 3 plus c2, 2 by 4 minus 1 by 3 plus c3, 3 by 5 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2 minus c2, 2 by 3 minus 1 by 2 minus c3, 3 by 4 minus 1 by 2 and bracket complete. So now I will put this equation in calci. So I will get 0 c2 plus 0.01667 c3, 0.01666 c3 minus 0.1667. So this is the required answer for integral 2. Okay, so this is a required answer for I2. Now we will solve for I3. So what is I3? I3 was 8 x square minus x dx. So this is become 8. Integration is very simple. Is x cube by 3 minus x square by 2, 1, 0. So I will get 8, 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2. So my required answer will be, yeah. So after solving this equation in calci, I will get minus 1.333. Okay. So now I will put this all I1, I2, I3 value in main equation. So main equation will become, so this is become 0 is equals to, so from this step number 1, I got the value of I1 is 0 plus C2 plus 1.5 C3. Okay, so value of I3, I2 is nothing but 0 C2 plus 0.1667 C3 minus 0.1667. So big small changes. This was a 0.0 0.166763. Yeah, and the value of I3 is minus 1.333. So after solving this, I will get 0 is equals to this C2 as it is, plus this is become 1.516673. And if I am solving this, so this is become, yeah, I am putting this I1, I2 and I3 equation. So I got the equation from I1 0 plus C2 plus 1.5 C3. From I2 I got this equation, and from I3 is minus, but already minus sign is there, so minus minus become plus. So if I am solving this, I will get C2, the equation of value of C3, and the value of constant will be 1.166. So this is the equation number 1 for W1. So same process we will solve for W2. So equation was, so this is W1 only, sorry, WI only. So what is WI? WI is nothing but x cube minus x into bracket dy by dx. So nothing but 1 plus C2 2x minus 1 plus C3 3x square minus 1 bracket complete minus 8 into WI, which is nothing but x cube minus x 0 to 1 dx. So similarly, I will solve this is for, I will consider this is I1, this consider I will, this is will be the I2 and this will be the I3. So I will solve for I1, I2 and I3. So let us consider with I1. So what is I1? I1 is nothing but 0 to 1 3x square minus 1 plus C2 2x minus 1 plus C3 3x square minus 1 bracket complete dx. So I will solve this. So I will get, first I will solve this bracket. So after solving this bracket, I will get 3x square plus C2 6x cube minus 3x square plus C3 9x raised to 4 minus 3x square. So this will be the 3x, I multiply 3x to whole bracket. Now I multiply this minus 1 to this bracket. So this will become minus 1, due to this sign will be changed. C2 2x minus 1 minus C3 3x square minus 1, this will become dx. Okay, so now I will solve this integration. So solving this integration, I will get 3x cube by 3 plus C2 6x raised to 4 upon 4 minus 3x cube by 3 plus C3 9x raised to 5 upon 5 minus 3x cube by 3, yeah, minus x minus C2 2x square by 2 minus x minus C3 3x cube by 3 minus x and bracket complete integral sign. Okay, so I will just solve this by, okay, so now I will put this upper limit and lower limit in this equation. So after putting this, I will get 3 by 3 plus C2 6 by 4 minus 3 by 3 plus C3 9 by 5 minus 3 by 3 minus 1 minus C2 2 by 2 minus 1 minus C3 3 by 3 minus 1. So this is my upper limit. So now we will put this equation in calci. So after putting this calci, we will get the coefficient of C2 and 1 equation. Okay. So we know that I1 has integral 3 throughout this equation. So we have to write 3 also here. So 3. So 3 also. 3 is there. So after solving this in calci, so I will get 0 plus 1.5 C2 plus 2.4 C3, equation number 1. So I already solved for I1, so now we have to solve for I2. So which is I2 is nothing but 0 to 1 x cube minus x into this 1 plus C2 2x minus 1 plus C3 3x square minus 1 dx. So now I will multiply this 2 bracket, and after that I will do integration for that. So for multiplication, so this is simply bracket multiplication, x cube plus C2 2x raised to 4 minus x cube plus C3 3x raised to 5 minus x cube. Then I will multiply this minus x throughout this bracket. I will get minus x minus C2 2x square minus x minus C3 3x cube minus x dx. So now I will do the integration for that. So after integrating this, I will get x raised to 4 by 4 plus C2 2x raised to 5 minus x raised to 4 plus C3 3x raised to 6 upon 6 minus x raised to 4 minus x square by 2 minus C2 2x cube by cube minus x square by 2 minus C3 3x raised to 4 by 4 minus x square by 2 0 to 1. So now I will put this upper limit and lower limit in this equation. After putting this, I will get, so this is become 1 by 4 plus C2 2 by 5 minus 1 by 4 plus C3 3 by 6 minus 1 by 4. This is become minus half. So minus C2 2 by 3 minus 1 by 2 minus C3 3 by 4 minus 1 by 2 bracket complete. Now I will put this equation in Calci. After putting this in Calci, I will get minus 0.0166 C2 plus 0 C3 minus 0.25. So this is my equation number 2. So this is my equation number 2. Now I will solve for I3. So I3 is nothing but 8 0 to 1 x cube minus x dx. If it is simple integration, after solving this I will get 8 x raised to 4 by 4 minus x square by 2 10. So this is nothing but 8 1 by 4 minus 1 by 2, and the value for that is, so value for that is minus. So this is my value integration for I3. So now I will put this I1, I2 and I3 in this equation. So I will get 0 is equals to, the value for I1 is this, which is nothing but 0 plus 1.5 C2 plus 2.4 C3. The value for I2 is equals to minus 0.0166 C2 plus 0 C3 minus 0.25, and the value for I3 is nothing but minus 2. So minus minus become plus 2. So through, if I'm solving this equation, so I will get 0 is equals to 1.5166 C2 plus 2.4C3 and this has become plus 1.75. So this is equation number. So this is, I already got one equation for W1, and so this is equation number 2. So I am written as a model number 2, and we got equation number 1 from W1 function, which is nothing but C2, 0 is equals to C2 plus 1.516667C3 plus 1.166. This was the equation number 1 which we find from W1 function. So now I will put these two equation in calci. So I will get the value of C2 and C3. So if I am solving this equation, so I will get 1.C2C2 and C3C3 and constant. So I will get this equation number 2, and from W1 function I got these equations. So if I am solving this equation in calci, I will get the value of C2 and C3, which will be the C2 value will be the minus 0.9594 and C3 value will be the minus 0.1361. Okay, so but my intention is to find the value of y of 0.3 and y of 0.6. So if I have to find this y of 0.3, I will refer this approximate solution, which is nothing but this. So y of 0.3 is nothing but the value of, you have to find the value of y when the value of x is 0.3. y of 0.6 is nothing but you have to find the value of 0.6. We have to find the value of y when the value of x is 0.6. So simply you have to put the x is equals to 0.3, and we already have a C2 and C3 equation value. So if I am putting this, so I will get 1.5300, and the y of 0.6 is nothing but 1.862.